it seems like just yesterday that all your favorite content creators and trading experts were screaming at the top of their lungs that the Bitcoin halving was already priced in and we might not see a big pump. Well, where are they now? It's now becoming apparent that Bitcoin is on an absolute tear and it doesn't look like it's slowing down anytime soon. As Bitcoin nears $10,000, the question is how long is it going to be before we can clear 20K and hit a new all-time high? I'm going to show you guys today when I believe that is going to happen and why it's probably a lot sooner than you think. Let's get it. Hello and welcome to BitBoy Crypto, your one-stop shop for all things related to Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. I make videos on this channel almost every single day. If you like what you hear or see, then please make sure to hit that subscribe button and click the bell to turn on notifications. If you'd like to take the conversation even further or ask me questions, then please make sure to join my Telegram group, the Bit Squad. We would love to see you there. Today, we're going to be taking a look at where Bitcoin is heading, and at the end of this video, I'm actually going to give you guys an exact date when I believe we will hit a new all-time high. The Bitcoin halving is a huge topic right now in cryptocurrency. Many people were expecting the price of Bitcoin to begin rising, precluding the halving in Q4 of 2019. When that did not happen, suddenly everyone was depressed. When the core crypto community starts to doubt Bitcoin, bearish content becomes very popular. Suddenly, YouTube videos are talking about Bitcoin crashing, and big trading accounts on Twitter start posting things like the halving is priced in fear that the price might not go up. People eat up this content because misery loves company. So when people feel scared and feel like they may have made a bad decision by getting into crypto, it makes them feel better to see people that are in the same boat. But it's amazing how much the sentiment can change so quickly. Bearish content is certainly not popular right now, as all of a sudden, we are no longer looking at how to get over 10K, but we're starting to entertain questions like, how high can Bitcoin go? When can Bitcoin hit $100,000? And the question we'll be looking at today, which is when will Bitcoin return to all-time highs? To me, this is the very most important date that we will encounter as the price of Bitcoin grows closer to previous all-time highs of about 20K. Now, the reasons I believe that this is such an important date extends past the simple fact that an all-time high is achieved. It's actually threefold. First, after each halving cycle, once Bitcoin hits all-time highs, the price then goes parabolic. Not immediately, but pretty quickly afterwards. And we are talking about absolutely huge parabolic runs. Secondly, the reason this will be very important is because this is the point where a huge influx of retail traders will begin to come into the space. Many people believe that Bitcoin was a giant bubble and it popped at the end of 2017. For those people, they believe that Bitcoin is a joke and we are all delusional. So for those people to eat their words, drop their judgments, and even get in on the Bitcoin train, then BTC is going to have to meet new all-time highs. Once this is achieved, we will see both new investors and old investors who were previously burned coming into the space. And the third reason is because this is when the media sentiment will help fuel a huge run. During the last bull market, the media played a huge role in pumping crypto to new investors. Unfortunately for those investors, the media picked up the hype train too late. And by the time they were all talking about Bitcoin and XRP and Ethereum, the bull market was almost over. And many of those people who listened to the media got burned. Fortunately for retail investors this go round, I believe that as soon as Bitcoin passes a new all-time high, that the media is going to whip people into hysteria. and it could be a good thing. You see, the last bull run, Bitcoin was at about 1,000 when it hit a new all-time high, about 1,200 actually. But it wasn't on people's radars really. Once it climbed to about 10K, it made a permanent impression on the media and business channels, and at this point, many more people began being exposed to Bitcoin. And even after the Bitcoin bubble popped, it has still stayed on the radar for business shows and channels like Squawk Box. So when we approach all-time highs again, it is already going to be a hot topic. This is going to fuel what may become known as the bull run to end all bull runs for Bitcoin. While I believe 100K is almost a certainty, I also believe that a $300,000 Bitcoin is not out of the question within the next 24 months. So when is this going to happen? When are we going to be able to hit new all-time highs? Well, if we use history as a gauge to determine this, then we obviously have to look at the previous halvenings. After the first halvening, it only took Bitcoin 3 months to reach all-time highs. After the second halvening, it took Bitcoin 8 months to hit a new all-time high. So there's a 5-month spread between the first halvening and the second halvening in terms of the amount of time it took them to reach an all-time high. However, when we look at the price environment for each of these halvenings, you'll see that they were actually quite different, and I'm gonna tell you why. If you look at the stock to flow chart here, you will actually see that the current cycle we are in right now much more closely resembles the first cycle than the second one. There's a huge run up to an all-time high, the price drops, then there is a seemingly bottomless pit that it falls into, and then it runs up again, looking like it will hit all-time highs quickly, only for it to come crashing down again before heading toward the halving. With the second cycle, we don't see that. But with the current cycle, it seems actually very close. And you may be wondering why that is. I believe that the second halving cycle is like one that we may never see again. The reason that cycle does not match the others is because the collapse of Mt. Gox occurred during that time. That threw everything out the window. I remember during this time receiving the crazy email that was written in Chinese from Mt. Gox, and I was trying to make sense out of it, wrap my head around it. And I was positive on that day after I processed everything that Bitcoin was done. I believed there was no way that it would come back. And I was not alone in that sentiment. Many people gave up on Bitcoin in February of 2014. This is why we never got a large relief pump like the first cycle and like we did last year for the current cycle. But the long and the short of it is that I believe that the second cycle is more of the outlier here. When you combine the media attention Bitcoin already receives with the historical precedent of the previous two halving cycles, I believe Bitcoin will hit a new all-time high approximately 4 to 5 months after the halving. I actually think the halving will occur a little before current estimates, and I think it'll happen around the 1st of May. So that being said, I believe Bitcoin will reach a new all-time high and pass $20,000 somewhere between September 1st and October 1st of this year. And if that happens, we could be somewhere near 50K to 75K by the end of the year, if not higher. But I like to be relatively conservative, so I don't sound crazy, and that's why I'm saying probably around 50K. Even though anyone watching this video who's not already in crypto, they probably already think that I'm crazy, family included. But let me know what you guys think. When do you believe we will be hitting new all-time highs? Do you think that I'm crazy? You probably do. You guys drop some comments down below and let me know. If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to smash the like button and also subscribe to the channel to become a member of the Bit Squad. Have a blessed day. BitBoy out.